Our very own expert in elder law, Gary Price, is back with us again. Today we're going to talk about one of the big mistakes people make when they're applying for Medicaid. And it's so intimidating to think about, I don't want to do this wrong, but I don't know how to do it right.
It can be. Yeah. It can be a rather difficult process for someone. The biggest mistake, and I hear this all the time, I talk with clients about elder law, and then when it gets to the subject of Medicaid, I hear this just about every week. Not just about, I hear this every week. And the person will say something like this: yeah, I know about Medicaid. I got my mom on Medicaid. When we put her in the nursing home, we had to spend all her money before she qualified.
And I've heard that so many times too, Gary.
And it's true. I'm sure she did have to spend all her mom's money before she qualified for Medicaid. But here's the point I want to make today. You don't have to, it doesn't matter if you have hundreds of dollars or hundreds of thousands of dollars, you don't have to spend all your money before you qualify for Medicaid. You do not. As I've mentioned before, the Medicaid rules include certain transactions or financial transfers you can make that are approved by Medicaid. And when you take advantage of those transactions, you can shelter, if not all your assets, certainly a substantial portion of your assets, and still qualify for Medicaid. So the problem with that is, or the hiccup to that is this: when you apply for Medicaid, that's why the book says about Medicaid in Indiana, the secrets to protecting your assets they won't tell you. Well, it's not because they're mean-spirited and don't want to tell you. The point is, the people you talk to, be it the caseworker at the Medicaid office, be it the employee at the business office of the nursing home, they can't tell you. That's practicing law. And so
they can't advise you in that legal capacity.
They're instructed not to discuss that with you for that very reason. That would be practicing law, which they're not qualified to do. So if you don't seek the advice of counsel and you walk into the Medicaid office and apply for Medicaid, then what they're going to do is continuously expect you to pay your nursing home bill until you don't have any money anymore, and then you qualify for Medicaid. And as I've always said, it doesn't have to be that way. Instead, talk to an attorney that's qualified in this area to incorporate and take advantage of some of those rules that are out there in order to shelter assets and still get qualified.
When should we start having this conversation with an attorney? What is the appropriate age, Gary?
Well, it really depends. In most situations, when we're in a crisis mode is when we've accepted the fact that they have to go into a nursing home. Certainly, at that point, that's the latest point. Now, once they get into a nursing home, it's not too late, but probably we can't shelter as many assets or as much of the asset estate if you'd contacted me before. But, you know, people who are just worried about it. I mean, if someone comes in and says that comment to me, my mom went into the nursing home, they're probably not going into a nursing home. They're not concerned about going into a nursing home right now. And they're wanting to talk to me about what can we do to shelter assets in the event I do have to go into the nursing home. Right. So it's never too early to have that conversation, but it's never too late to have the conversation as well. And again, to take advantage of the rules that are out there that are available.
How do we get your book?
The book, you call my office, and I'll be happy to send a copy of the book to you at no charge. My phone number is 812-479-8721. Again, just call the office. I'll be happy to send you a copy.
Thank you, Gary. Always informative. We'll be back with more Local Lifestyles after this.
This portion of Lifestyles is sponsored by Gary Price, elder law attorney.